Nulis sa letter ng mga kasipaan ni Oliver, but a crisis carrying on the mission that Oliver started. So to Chris and others, the other members of the board, and to our other distinguished guests here tonight and good evening. I congratulate the Coalition of Filipino Community Organizations in Kuwait for organizing this event tonight, mainly because it provides an opportunity for our organizations here to recognize our fellow Filipinos who have, shall we say, accomplished much in their years here in Kuwait. Foremost among whom are the mga kasambahays or mga domestic workers who have been working here a long time. All of us are here in Kuwait, mainly as a matter of, shall we say, economic necessity. Most of us found opportunities here that are not available to us either at home or elsewhere for one reason or another. The journey for many has been a very challenging one, and for a few it has been particularly, shall we say, tragic. But for the greater part, as evidenced by the presence here today, the Filipino community in Kuwait has done well. And I am happy that the coalition is organizing this activity because it provides not simply the matter of recognition of the efforts of those who have done exemplary well, but also your own individual efforts and sacrifices. So for you to be able to be here tonight, to enjoy each other's company, to enjoy sharing the pride that we have in recognizing our fellow Filipinos, this is an important event. The Embassy of the Republic of the Philippines here in Kuwait is committed to improving services for all of our Filipinos. We started by looking for better facilities, and we have also been gradually streamlining and improving our processes and procedures at the embassy. This is a mission that will go on in the next few years, and it will be shall we say, as part of the Philippine government's program to improve services for Filipinos, it will actually be part of the bureaucratic goals. One of streamlining, one of increasing efficiency, and eventually being more effective in the delivery of services. But in doing so, the Philippine Embassy, of course, also relies on the community to provide not just support, but more importantly, feedback. Your feedback is important because it helps us identify gaps, shortcomings, and additional areas of improvement. Okay. There may have been a time before when I think the community, not just here, everywhere, even in the Philippines, Filipinos will complain about lack of responsiveness from government. But times have changed, and technology has provided government the means to actually carry out vast improvements in services of Filipinos. So, in the last 5 and 10 years, we are gradually upscaling the quality of services. And the government will continue to do so in the foreseeable future. Bound only or restricted only by limitations of financial or, shall we say, in terms of lack of financial resources. Ngayon po, tayo pong mga Pilipino rito sa Puri. We are more or less, I think, aware of the services provided by the Philippine government to each and every OFW. But hanggang ngayon, we still get inquiries, we still notice that there is still some lack of information, dissemination, and lack. But there's some confusion sometimes about exactly what the benefits are extended by government of Philippines. I think even now, mayroon mga tao pa rin alam o pa rin naiintindihan na, for example, may mga malaking pakinabang pag sila ay membro ng kapili kapag dating pero nag-OWA records. At the very, and it's very simplest, we still have a lot of Filipinos who do not realize that this is very important to renew your passport before it expires. Maraming instances na nangyayari na kailan expire na yung passport sa kanilang number. Well, human nature sometimes leads us to forget, but as foreigners in a different country, we should be more conscious of these things. Having passports, having visa, CUID, and having status and memberships of our Philippine, as shall we say, social organizations, such as PAGBIG, SSS,
Reina, huwag ako ba magpicture ta?